So, good morning everyone. Today I have to give a recorded class due to some unavoidable circumstances. I could not give live class. So, nevertheless, let us come to the last topic, which is yesterday we did properties of S block and P block. Now we are discussing properties of D block and F block. So, first we have to write the electronic configuration. First, we will have to write the electronic configuration. Now, students, please check those electronic configurations ending with D. Now, those electronic configurations which are ending with D, you are having an S. You are not having P. The electronic configurations which are ending with D, you are not having a P. You are having a S. So, suppose 4S, 3D. So, 4S can be 1, 4S can be 2. Because I said it is for chromium 4S1, 3D5. And for copper it is 4S1, 3D10. Again 4S2, 3D4, 4S2, 3D3. So, S can be 1 or 2. So, S can be 1 or 2. After that comes D. Now, D configurations can be D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7, D8, D9, D10. So, D can be from 1 to 10. But here it was 4S and here it was 3D. So similarly, if you go further, you will get 7S, 6D. You will get 5S, 4D. If you go aage agar jayega. So for the time being, you are getting 4S, 1, 3D, 4, 4S, 1, 3D, 5, 4S, 2, 3D, 5. So 4 and 3. So what I write is that D is 1 to 10. So if it is 4, which means if it is N, this one will be always 1 less than this N. So this is 4, this is 3, this is 5, this is 6, this is 5, this is 7, this is 6. So if this is N, this will be N minus 1. So 4S1, 3D1, 4S2, 3D1, 4S2, 3D3, 4S1, 3D5. So here it is 4, here 4 minus 1, 3. It is 5, 5 minus 1, 4. So this is the general electronic configuration of D block elements. Number 2, D block elements, students, are also called transition elements. D block elements are also called transition elements because they have unpaired d orbitals. Unpaired means d orbitals are like this, no? So they have maximum this type of orbitals. Means unpaired, not paired, alone. All are alone. So that's why they are called transition, means they are not paired. They are D1. D1 means one electron. D2, 2 electrons. D3, 3 electrons. D4, 4 electrons. If it is D7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Still there are unpaired electrons or not. So that's why they are called transition, because they are having unpaired d orbitals, except zinc, because students, zinc is 3D10. Zinc ka last pe 3D10. 3D10 means all are filled up, entire d is filled up. So zinc will not be considered as transition element. D block elements also have metals and non-metals among themselves, and from D block we get the F block elements. So D block elements are called specially transition elements, and D block elements are not only good catalysts, they are good paramagnetic compounds, they form alloys, and they can form a lot of compounds. So D block elements are very versatile in nature, and hence D block elements are called transition elements. Now coming to F block, similarly, you see, whenever you will use F block, when you use D block, so if S is going with M, then F will come after D. Is first S will come, then D will come, then F will come. P is over. P will not come now. S, D and F. So for F, the configuration is NS, then N minus 1 D, like this, same. And if for S it is N, for D is it N minus 1, then for F it will be N minus 2. One orbital less. Because maximum period is 7. So 7 minus 1, 6, 7 minus 2, 5. So, students, actinoid and lanthanoid series have maximum 4F and 5F series. 4F series is called lanthanoids and 5F series is called actinoids. So maximum it is 5F because N can be maximum 7. So if N is with S, D is with N minus 1 and F is with N minus 2. So F has how many electrons? 14. Just because D has 10, so F has 14. So 1, 2, 14. But if here D you have taken full, but S is limited. So similarly here F is taken full, D is limited, that is 0 to 2. And NS, 2. S will be filled up. So this is the general electronic configuration of F block. This is not required, but still I have given you. NS2, N minus 1, D 0 to 2, N minus 2, F 1 to 14. So when you take D full, S will be limited. And when you take F full, D will be limited. F block elements has two series. One is lanthanoids, which is 4F, and actinoids, which is 5F. Lanthanoids and actinoids are radioactive in nature, except promethium. So lanthanoids means lanthanum series, actinoids means actinium series. And the chemistry of F block elements is difficult to study, because maximum of F block elements are radioactive in nature. Maximum of F block elements are radioactive in nature. And the elements which come after uranium are called transuranium elements. So this is a short summary of D block and F block. So we have studied about S block, P block, D block and F block. And with this, the introduction part is over. Next class, means from Monday, if I am there, then I will teach you the next topic, which is trends in the physical properties. But in case if I cannot teach, or suppose if I get admitted for due to some issues, then chapter 5 videos will be given to you, as I said earlier in the meeting. So with this we come to the end of today's video. Thank you for watching it, and go to the notes which I am sending in the Google Classroom. Thank you very much. Stay safe and good luck.